Hi everyone, I'm Dennis Foley from Acoustic Fields. Today we're going to talk about reverberation. It's a widely used term, but I believe kind of misunderstood a little bit. It's applied to small rooms when really it's a large room phenomenon. But that said, we can use it in small rooms for a guideline. Today we're going to talk about reverberation and large room applications and why it's really important. We're going to talk about the definition, the RT60 time, how you arrive at the RT60 time and what it's all about, what it actually involves. And then the measurement procedure itself. There's some do's and don'ts in measuring, and we see a lot of errors in this, so we'll talk a little bit about those. And then in small rooms, what its application is and some guidelines that it can help us out a little bit. Okay, back to our discussion on reverberation. Let's talk about reverberation as a large room phenomenon. What do we really have occurring in reverberation? We have a series of reflections off the wall surfaces. Our stage and our seating area is a broad-based area. There's a lot of surface area here. So we have multiple reflections off the wall surfaces. So our goal with reverberation is to try to get an equal distribution of all the energy within a big room uniformly spread across the seating area. So reverberation is mainly a large room phenomenon and it's frequency dependent. So at all frequencies, we want all sound to sound the same. So you know when you've been to large room auditoriums that you have certain seats that are good visually and certain seats that are good acoustically, and the goal is to try and find a balance there. But as engineers, what large room acoustic people try to do is get a uniform decay rate or reverberation coverage in all the seated areas in a large room situation. So let's look at the definition of reverberation. Really, it's a pressure decay rate. It's a way of figuring, once you interject pressure into the room, how long does it take in the time domain for that energy to drop 60 dB? And that'll give you a rate, an RT rate at frequencies and octave bands. So it's a decay rate. It's a measure, if you will, in more common language of how live or how hot the room is. So it's a time interval for the pressure to drop at least 60 dB. And then we measure it at each frequency and each octave band. So we introduce pressure into the room, shut the energy source off, and do our measurements. All right, let's talk about the measurement of reverberation. And this is an issue that's a little bit tricky in small rooms because we usually have a left and a right channel, a two-channel system producing energy into the room. What does that do? It causes a lot of reflections off the boundary surfaces. So are we really getting an accurate reverberation time in a small room with this kind of setup? A better approach would be to energize the room in the so-called center part of the room, spread the energy out more evenly in the room, and then you'd get a more accurate decay rate, if you will, at certain frequencies and certain octave bands. So this is, I think, where some of the confusion lies, because reverberation is really a large room phenomenon, but we do use it in small room measurements. Some people say, well, if it can be measured, it has to be important. Well, maybe, but it is really a large room phenomena, and it's applied to small rooms, and I think that's where people need to have the understanding. So in order to take an accurate reverberation time reading, we need to energize the room equally. So if we put our sound source or energy source in the middle of the room and radiate out, we can get a more even energy distribution in the room and thus a more even RT60 time. Okay, let's talk a little bit about the applicability, if you will, of RT60 times in small rooms. Well, we've all heard the expression too dead, too live. As it pertains to reverberation times in rooms. So reverberation time does have some applicability in small rooms, even though it is a large room phenomenon. When we use the term too dead, that really means that our reverberation times in the room are less than 2/10 of a second. That's a general guideline that we use in small room acoustics. If it's greater than 0.5 seconds, then it's a little bit too lively or too hot, sometimes is the expression. So the normal range is, you know, somewhere between 0.2 and 0.5 seconds reverb time in your small room environment for music. And that's usually the objective we're after here. We did some large room measurements the other day in a cathedral, and it had 100-foot high ceilings and 200-foot walls, and we had a 6-second reverberation time in some of the lower frequencies. So you can see it's a wide range of delays here that we're discussing. But in most of our listening rooms that we use for music, we try to keep it between 0.2 and 0.5 seconds. There's a lot of variability between those two numbers, and everybody's tastes are a little bit different. Some people like the fact that it's a little bit more lively. In critical listening rooms, it's a little more dead, thus where the term live end, dead end concept came out of. So it depends on usage and your personal choices, what reverberation times that you prefer. But in small room acoustics, we like the 0.2 to 0.5 second range.